Buongiorno. Welcome to Cooking with Eddie, La Mia Cucina. Yet another episode and a new idea. Today is early summer. It's time for special vegetables and fruits. And I'm all in red today because I'm going to do something I've never done before with a special vegetable and fruit. This, as you can see, is rhubarb. And these are unbelievable strawberries. Guess what I'm going to make today? Yep, strawberry rhubarb pie. Never done it before. We'll see how it turns out. I'm real nervous about it, especially the crust, because it's one of those lattice work crusts, so I'm not really good about that. But it's one of Maraca's favorites. She asked for it. We went to a farmer's market this morning, got some fresh rhubarb, and we went to a neighbor's house who said, I've got some rhubarb, come and get it. So we got plenty of it, and there'll be some in the freezer. We got so much of it. These strawberries are unbelievable. I mean, look at this. This is a strawberry. Look at that. That is a strawberry. Mm-hmm. That tastes like a strawberry. Okay, so strawberries, rhubarb, sugar, cinnamon, salt. For the crust, flour and butter and shortening, and we'll start with that. It has to go in the freezer, the refrigerator for about an hour once I make the dough, separate it into two. And when that's done in the refrigerator, we'll get to the filling. So we'll see what this is going to be like. Keep your fingers crossed. I'm glad that you're here. Thank you for coming, and we'll have some strawberry rhubarb pie, hopefully, by the end of the show. See you in a bit. Okay, so I'm going to start with the dough. I've got 3 cups of all-purpose flour. I've got a tablespoon, just shy of a tablespoon of sugar, and a little shy of a teaspoon of salt. And I'm going to mix that together. And then I'm going to cut in some butter and some shortening. I may need a little water to moisten it up, but I'm just going to cut this in. It takes a little more time, but I think you can be more certain of what the consistency is going to be like. The recipe calls to put it in a Cuisinart, but I don't have much luck with that. It gets over hot, or the dough's not quite right. Bit. Get the feel of it. And a little bit of water, maybe a tablespoon at a time. Just a little bit of water. Ball. That feels like dough. Okay. Yep. There we go. Okay. That's about right. Okay, I'm going to cut this in half and flatten it out into a disc and stick that in the refrigerator for about an hour. And then we'll get on to the filling. Dough. Well done. See you in about an hour. Okay, so the dough is in the refrigerator chilling. It's going to be almost an hour. And in the meantime, we'll make the filling for the pie. So this is what rhubarb has been cleaned and cut into about half-inch pieces. It's kind of like a celery, almost. You can take a look at that. It certainly looks like a celery family. And this is about 3.5 cups. And this is 3.5 cups of the strawberries that I've sliced, half, maybe more, depending on the size of the strawberry. And now we're just gonna put it all together. And together with the sugar, the brown sugar, the cinnamon, salt, and cornstarch. And I'm just gonna mix that up. And this will, the liquid from the, both the rhubarb and the strawberries will make the filling thicken. And that's it. So all we have to do now is wait for the dough. I'll roll it out and put the filling in. We'll have some strawberry rhubarb pie with dinner. I gotta figure out what I'm gonna have for dinner. All right, I'm gonna preheat the oven to 400, work on the dough, and then stick it in the oven when we're ready. See you in a minute. All right, this has been out there for about an hour. I'm gonna roll this out to about a 13-inch circle. This is where I get nervous. I'm not really a dough guy. I'm not really a baker. So this is really uncharted waters here. You know what I mean? That makes me nervous. Makes me nervous. I'm new at this. Must be 13 inches. Let's see. Oops, see? Oh boy. It's falling apart here. Might be a disaster. It's falling apart. This isn't good. This is not good. It's falling apart. You know what? I don't know. Destroyed it. So much for that. I'm just gonna press it in. Well, that's a disaster. She'll never know. Don't tell her about the crust. All right. We're gonna put this in here. Filled to the brim. Okay, let's see what happens with the other crust. See if I can make that work. Cross your fingers. Oh my God. Okay. Well, I think I've salvaged the crust. The top looks much better. Don't tell her about what happened at the bottom. I won't tell if you don't tell. Now, the last thing I'm gonna do is I took an egg yolk and a little bit of water, and I'm gonna glaze the top of this, and this should make it brown up nicely. hopefully keep the crust together. I've got the oven ready to go at 400. I'm sure there's a better way to do this, and I'm sure you're all experts at it. But you know, it's about the spirit of adventure. That's what I'm telling myself. But the celery, I mean, the rhubarb was just amazing to pick from the garden. It was such a sweet thing to allow us to do. And this is a, you know, this is a pie that I didn't grow up with. Marika loves this. It's a summer pie. All right, so we're all sort of glazed over the top here. I'm gonna put this on a baking sheet. And bake it at 400 for about 20 minutes and then lower it to, I think, 350, I'll check on that. And cook it for about an hour and 20 minutes or so, just so that it really forms up and the juices form and all that. So, here we go. Cross your fingers. It's going to taste great. It may look like hell, but it's going to taste great. Okay. In the oven with you. Strawberry rhubarb. Thank you very much. We'll see what happens. Please. Well, there it is. It came out. Don't tell her about the crust, but it looks pretty good. Smells great. I'll let you know how it tastes later. So here it is. It's summertime. Strawberry rhubarb pie. The crust, good luck. In the meantime, thanks for coming. I hope you enjoyed it. I had a good time. Our secret, please, my secret, I hope, is safe with you. But, you know, once this goes online, everyone's going to know. But another one of those blooper reels. Here it is. But it sure looks good. Thanks for coming. Like us down below. Subscribe us. Stay safe. Cooking with Eddie. La mia cucina. Ciao. Buon appetito. Ciao. Marika, your pie's ready. Here you go. Here, try it. How's it look?
Ooh, yeah. That looks wonderful.
Yeah. Taste it. It's like that. Good?
Rhubarb is good.
Oh, good. Hey, how's the crust?
Now, let me see. Oh, my.
Good, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Great. 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 I'm so glad you like it. Okay, guys, here's the deal on the crust. I had to follow a recipe for the strawberry rhubarb pie, which had a crust recipe included. I shouldn't have followed it. It was terrible. I should have used a crust I've always used for my pumpkin pie, my pecan pie, and that's the one I've printed below. Follow that one. It works every time, tried and true. It'll make two crusts. You'll have the bottom, you'll have the top. And it'll won't fall apart when you put it all together. Hey, I was following directions. I'm an actor, what can I say? Thank you so much for coming one more time. Cooking with Eddie, La Mia Cucina. See you next time. We might tackle an Italian dessert, another one, called Baba Rum. Baba. Bye-bye. Ciao, ciao. Thanks for coming.